G'day legends, welcome back to the garage. Today we're testing out the Fobo Bike 2 tire pressure monitoring system. The guys here reached out to me and asked me to test this one out on the 890R. So we are gonna do that. It's gonna be a very quick install. We'll even go for a ride, check that out and show you what it's like as we're out on the road. Tire pressure monitoring, look, it's really important. A lot of bikes do come out with them these days. The KTM comes out as an added extra, but I like the idea that we can actually put these onto the valves pretty quickly, straight away, install the app onto your phone, whether it be Android or Apple, and get it all set up. It's really easy to do. I'll show you that process there. We'll go for a ride, check it out. If you want one of these, make sure you click the link down below. Okay, it's an affiliate link. I get a little bit to assist the channel. It's at no extra cost to you guys, so I'd really appreciate that. And if you do want to help the channel, make sure you subscribe, like the video, and share it as well. Okay, let's get this thing on the 890, and then we'll go for a ride. Okay, so here it is. So we're going to give this a good run here, the Fobo Bike 2. I'm quite keen to get into this and have a look now. Beautiful black. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, so let's open it up. You've got a couple of battery warnings there. Of course, you don't want to be doing that. There's a scanning QR code for the user guide, which is great because you may need that at some stage or another. Okay, so these are the two units right here. Let me just unplug that one. Whoop. Nice. Nice and shiny and black. That's going to change very quickly. All right, so we'll pull those out. Pull the rest of the box apart as well. Is there anything else in there? No, that's all of it there. Brilliant. Yeah, so tire pressure monitoring systems. The first time I had one was on the GS. And then I had to get my own for the Africa Twin, which was pretty good, worked out pretty well. And now to grab this unit here is even better. Love the packaging. Now let's start with this one. So you can get them installed into the rim, so those features are right there. We might look at that later on down the track. We'll see. We'll see indeed. But I actually don't mind the way that these look and the way that they are. Pretty neat little unit, aren't they? You've got the tightening tool for the security. So there you get four little lugs to make sure no one steals from that little anti-theft device, which I'll show you in a second. And then we'll pull this sucker apart as well. And I'll just grab my knife. Get the old Leatherman out, try not to cut myself in half. So it seems like they give you everything that you need to get these little things onto the bike. That's awesome. Okay, brilliant. Devices, locking lugs, which is just nice and easy to do. And then we're gonna move over to the bike. Give me two of those. Keyring, not sure why, but I'll figure that out later. Cool. Okay, so we're gonna download the app. We'll get onto the app, we'll program it all. There you go, 24/7 monitoring, slow and fast leak detection, which I think is pretty crucial. You can share it with other Fobo users, which I think Mark's going to get one of these, so we'll give that a shot. Two-level theft deterrent, that's your little lugs here, and very easy to install because if I can do it, anyone can. Don't know if you can see that or not. Okay, let's take these down to the bike, and then we'll give this a shot. All right, let's download the app. And going into the Play Store here, we're gonna go to Fobo Bike 2. You see it comes up straight away, pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna install that. We're gonna add a brand new bike. We go into the motorbike. Gives you a lot of selections, your pushy, a trike if you'd like as well, and a reverse trike or whatever you wanna call those things there. Excellent. Next, profile name. Let's go with KTM 890. That looks good to me. Next, pretty easy to do. All right, this is where we get to set our pressures. Alert at zero pressure, yes. We definitely want that one there. Minimums, okay, so front tire. Now, we usually go pretty low when we're out and about, so I will set my minimums to 17. Recorded at, what did I say, 31, 32, and then the max. So how about we go maximum up to, Let's see here. 45, and if it gets over 45, that's a bit dodge. We'll quickly grab the pressure and let's have a look at where it's being recorded at. Okay, 24 and a half is where we're doing it. There we go. So set to 24, done. Now the rear tire, same again. I know that we've recorded that at 33, so I'm going to put that in there. Now the minimum again, straight down, will go to 17. The maximum will go to 45 again as well. Done. Okay, gives me a good idea. Next, vehicle make. So put your details of the bike in. 890 ADVR. Year 2023. There we go. Okay, that's all done. Brilliant. Now we can put a photo in there. Choose from the gallery. Where's the stuff from the Wadigans? Here we go. Pick a nice one. How about that one looks good. All right. Oh, it's a bit shady. Might replace that later on, but that's all good. All right, now we have nothing installed. This is where we get into it. Okay. It gives you all of the instructions. We're going to screw the sensor onto the rear tire position. Okay, so let's get our rear tire sensor. All right. So, this is how you loosen them up to get the batteries out. I recommend doing this. Okay. There we go. See how easy it is to replace that battery? It's pretty good. Waterproof, dustproof, and everything else. So that's all in there. That's all good to go. Love the logo. Okay, we're going to screw the sensor under the rear tire. Touch it with the mobile and press proceed. Okay. Here we go. In it goes. All right, you can see it installing now. I've got it leaning up against the sensor. Excellent. Very easy indeed. Awesome, all right, let's go and do the front one. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna screw this one on, full pressure, good. Then touch the sensor with your phone, hit proceed, and we're installing. Cool. All right, so the front's already showing it's high, and there's your alarm. So that's a pretty good alarm. So what I can actually do, let's have a look. Settings, front tire, max 30. Well, let's bring that up to about 37. There we go. Save. Excellent. All right. So there's your interface, and it's pretty good. I think it does move around. Yeah, excellent. So if you do use your phone, you can actually keep it on sitting here like this, and that works out pretty well. You can tap into the screen, and, well, maybe not that one, is it that one? That's it there. It will show you all your details. So you've got your temperature, your pressures, your current pressures. It will give you a graph, which is pretty neat. I like the way it does that for you as well. We'll test that when we go and hit the road. Okay, and that's pretty much it. So there's the app. That's how it will stand. What's this one here? There you go, your current pressure settings, good to go. You still got your profile. You can change everything, your PSIs, pressure, anything you want, Fahrenheit to centigrade, which is good. You've got all your choices down through here for what kind of alarms you want. Keep screen on, dark mode, group ride, which we'll test with someone else when we get chance to. Crash analysis, let's try not to test that as well. and then you've got all your other bits and pieces that you can play with. Now, this is your permission setting. So notifications, that's done. Location, you can enable that. And of course, it's going to drain your battery. Everything else is done. We're going to save that one there, done. Okay, there we go. That is Fobo Bike 2. Very easy to set up, very easy to install. If someone like me can do it, then I'm pretty sure you could do it as well. So all we have to do now is get out, give it a run, and we'll go and see what the temperature's like. You can see here it is updating itself every few seconds, ranging up to 30, there we go, 30 seconds. That's pretty good. Don't mind, it's giving me current temperature, battery power, and PSI. So we will move these around. That front tire is pretty high. I might bring that down. All right, I'll get onto that now. Okay, if it does, let's do this. There you go. Gives you your alert. That's pretty good. What I'm also hoping is that with the Garmin XT2 that I've got, that I'll get the notifications coming through the helmet as well. So if there's any issues, so I can have this in the bag, I reckon that should be good to go. All right, I'm going to reduce that pressure down. It's a bit high in the front. And we'll get out and go for a blast. Good times. All right, guys, so we're out on the bike. We're going to give this a run. Let's just see how the app looks when we're out on the road. Fobo Bike 2 is just up here. Okay, so it's just going to sync up and get everything ready. You can see from yesterday when we did the initial video, it was the last time the app did its sync. And it will take a few seconds to come together. Then what you'll see is the temperatures come in and then the pressures. So there's our front at 28.6, rear at 34.4. Not too bad at all. So we can, now I still need to get used to how this works when we pop it on its side there. There it is. Okay, excellent. So we can monitor everything. You see every 30 seconds it updates itself with the Bluetooth. So what we'll do is we'll head out for a bit of a run around the block. And then go from there. I do need some fuel. You see I haven't got a lot. And for those that have seen on my Instagram page, ADV Brett, you see we've cracked 1,000 kilometers. Bit of a milestone. It's not too bad at all, actually. Very happy with that. All right, so let's get going. And let's go and see what we can do with this. You'll see how the app works and everything that you need to take into consideration. So it'll be a short one as we head around the block. All right. And we're just going to keep it to the local area. Let me bring that down. There we go. It's a 60 zone all around here. So we're just going to keep it on the limit. But you'll see that there'll be an increase in temperature. Pressures will come up slightly. You probably can't see that in the glare, but I've got the screen recording there for you to have a look at as well. And you can just watch how it all changes and what it does. And then when we stop at the petrol station, I'll just show you a couple of bits there. I like the way this works. You can have the screen up all the time, but of course that's going to kill your battery. So, you know, it's always good to turn it off. All right, so I've now got the XCOM Pro running in the NexWed 3, so I've got the audio up and running. Now this is all connected to the Garmin XT2, the Zumo here. So what will happen if it's a weird three screens? It's a bit much, isn't it? Certainly is a bit much. But with the three screens running there, it won't happen all the time. The reason I've got the quad lock is mainly for the drone, to be honest. And the phone will either be in my pocket or in the tank bag. So yeah, what will happen is if I get a low pressure sensor, the notification will also come up on the screen of the XT2. And I'll also hear the alarm through the XCOM Pro, which I'm quite keen to, quite keen to test that out. Oh dear. It works really well. I really like it. I like the fact that I've got the app. You guys might remember on the Twin, I had the little device that was sitting on the handlebars, and it just takes up more real estate on the bar work, which I'm quite happy to get that off and keep it in the phone. And the one thing that I really love is that I can just check the pressures before I leave.
Keep an eye on throughout the day if I really need to. It'll alert me if anything goes wrong, which I'm pretty happy with as well. But then when I bring the pressures down when we do some off-roading, then I can also keep an eye on that and bring it down to the pressures that I like and just maintain them there. So all round, really good unit to have, to be honest. Really good unit, very happy. Fobo Bike 2, if this is something you think you can use in your bike, whether it be an adventure bike, a Harley, your street bike, anything like that, check out the link below and go and grab yourself one. I reckon they're awesome. All right, what's our petrol price today? $1.72.9. Okay, we'll do that. I'll fill it up and then we'll go and duck around the corner and have a look at it from there. Sounds like a plan. Cool. I'll just duck over here real quick. And I've got to reset everything, so I cannot remember how to do this. Let's see, ride mode, throttle, bike info, trip. Trip one, reset trip. Trip two, reset trip. Trip one. All right, that's everything reset. Outstanding. All right, let's get going. We'll go and find somewhere to have a quick look at Fobo Bike 2. There we are. How good. Brilliant. Drop this down a little bit, put some temperature in the tires, and then just have a quick look at that. Should be pretty flush, actually. Nice to feel a bit of warmth coming through the legs. 1,000K service is done, everything's sorted out. Next video you'll see me doing is a dash cam system from Inov. That's going to be coming up very soon, so keep an eye out for that. I might actually duck into here. Okay, now you see it's a bit dull and gloomy. Chances are it is going to rain at any moment now. Okay, let me take the gloves off for a moment. So Fobo Bike 2, yes, I do approve greatly. The unit itself is brilliant, the way it works here. If you can't see that, I'll put that up on the screen properly. But if you tap in, there's our front tire. Gives you all your details here, got the latest firmware, that's good. But then you get your pressure and temperature, and you can see the temperature slowly coming up. We'll go into a bigger graph, and it, you can go back and forward to different parts of the day, but it's good to be able to measure that and monitor that, and it will keep a nice run on how your tyres are looking. You can go in and change these any way, shape or form, so that's pretty good as well. There's your increase in temperature. Pressure slowly increasing just due to that temperature. You've got your temperature in the tyre now, your battery level as well. You can go in and change your bike. I like the fact that you can flick this over. Very, very easy app to use. So this is something you're looking for, then definitely have a look at it. Fobo Bike 2, to be able to shut the app down, it will stay open. So you've got to go into your notifications. Fobo Bike 2 is running. You can see I'm recording this. Hit disable, and that's it. Save your battery. And it's as easy as that. How good is that? So that's Fobo Bike 2. I'll turn that off, but if I turn it back on, and I'll just leave it running in the background, that's on the phone there, and then we can get going. So tire pressure monitoring system, if you are looking for one, I do highly recommend something like this, and go and have a look at it. I've got all the links down below in the description, so check that out. And like I said before, they're affiliate links, so I'll get a little bit of a assistance for the channel. Ooh. And that's always gonna help. And if you've got any questions, well, just drop it down in the links below, guys. I'll be more than happy to answer them. And we're going to be testing this long term as well. You're going to be seeing me use this for quite some time. It's a great unit. Let me just open some vents up down here. It's getting a bit warm. Yeah, it's a great unit. It's great to be able to have it in your phone and to see how that works.